Kalpana Chawla's cause of death and the real cause of the space shuttle disaster. Greetings and welcome. We have a motivational tale about the life of Kalpana Chawla to share with you today. She made history by becoming the first woman of Indian descent to travel into space. Her journey is characterized by tenacity, passion, and a desire to achieve greatness. Join us as we examine Kalpana Chawla's remarkable life and the impact she has on the world. The first person of Indian descent to travel into space was Kalpana Chawla, who also created history by doing so. Over the course of her life, she took part in two space missions. Her first space mission was successful, but on her second trip back to orbit, something unexpected happened. This catastrophe turned the space shuttle into a deadly fireball, leaving the astronauts' names in history. On that day, a fatal accident involved the Columbia space shuttle carrying Kalpana Chawla and the crew. This aroused concerns about whether NASA had foreseen such a catastrophe and what had motivated Kalpana Chawla's extraordinary trip prior to that tragic incident. Let's look into it more. Kalpana Chawla, who was born on March 17, 1962, in Karnal, Haryana, emanated confidence from a young age. Out of her four siblings, she was the youngest. Up till 1976, Kalpana attended Tagore Balakirtan School for her elementary education. Kalpana graduated from Punjab Engineering College with a bachelor's degree in aeronautical engineering in 1982. She was the only female to accomplish this at the time. She continued her education at the University of Texas, where she met and wed Jean Perry Harrison in 1983, to get a master's degree in aeronautical engineering. The University of Colorado awarded Kalpana a PhD in aerospace engineering in 1988. She started working for NASA in the same year. She obtained American citizenship in 1991, and in December 1994, she joined the 15th crew of space tourists. NASA hired her in 1996 as a specialist and primary robotic arm operator for their first space mission after being impressed by her abilities. The STS-87 Columbia space shuttle launched from the Kennedy Space Center on November 19, 1997. Together with five other crew members, Kalpana Chawla successfully spent 15 days and 16 hours in space before landing on the planet on December 5, 1997. She went into space for the first time as a woman of Indian descent. After the first mission's success, NASA chose Kalpana Chawla to go in space again in 2001. Launch delays for this mission, known as STS-107, were experienced many times because to Columbia Space Shuttle Columbia's ongoing issues. On February 1, 2003, the Columbia departed from the Kennedy Space Center for its 28th and final flight following 2 years of troubleshooting. Disaster struck during this operation, which lasted 15 days, 22 hours, and 20 minutes. The crew felt a violent shock as the spacecraft re-entered Earth's atmosphere, followed by breathing difficulties. The crew members suffered a horrible and tragic end as their bodies heated and their blood boiled as a result of the lack of air. The Columbia's interior structure collapsed under the intense pressure of the surrounding gases as a result of the loss of control. There was no hope as the shuttle changed into a track of white smoke. The accident's cause remained unknown for many years, with many people speculating that the crew had made a mistake. But a careful study by NASA found that the accident was caused by insulating foam. The low temperature of the liquid fuels utilized in the shuttle's rockets was crucially maintained by this foam. Nevertheless, a piece of insulation foam that came loose during launch impacted a reinforced carbon fiber panel in the left wing and made a sizable hole in it. The tragic catastrophe was caused by the damage that resulted from the shuttle's inability to survive the high heat upon re-entry. The NASA investigative team accurately recreated the contact between the foam and the wing to support this finding. The outcomes proved that the accident was actually caused by the insulation foam colliding with the wing. They performed a number of tests, repeatedly slamming the foam component into the wing at an 804 km per hour speed. The findings were clear: the foam damage sustained at launch was the actual cause of the Columbia Space Shuttle's untimely demise. It was unexpectedly discovered that the NASA Mission Management Team, MMT, had been aware of the foam breakup problem during launch. The crew members were not informed of this knowledge, however, and were therefore uninformed of any potential risks. According to some theories, NASA did not want the astronauts to become alarmed and spend their final days in fear. Although the crew's fate was known, it is still unclear why this important information was withheld. The heroic crew members vanished among the stars, leaving a vacuum that would never be filled as they followed the debris that the Columbia accident had spread in space. The Indian government announced on February 5, 2003, that all weather-related satellites launched by ISRO would carry the moniker Kalpana satellites, in honor of Kalpana Chawla, in recognition of their groundbreaking accomplishments. Other programs and initiatives, such as the Kalpana Chawla scholarships, were also given her name. In addition, NASA recognized Kalpana Chawla by giving her name to a supercomputer and a mountain on Mars. Numerous people are still inspired by her unwavering energy and desire to reach the heavens and planets. Even if Kalpana Chawla, the bright star of today, may have become lost among the heavenly bodies, her legacy endures. Thank you for joining us on this journey through the extraordinary life of Kalpana Chawla. Her legacy as a trailblazer and a symbol of perseverance continues to inspire us all. Let us remember her courage and dedication as we reach for our own dreams. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more fascinating stories. Until next time, goodbye and namaskar.